Recently, we had a very specific request from one of our major customers. They wanted to use MATLAB to generate sine waves out of all four channels of our DNX AO364. This is an analog four-channel waveform generator interface board. This customer is using the generated sine waves as external excitations for various LVDT and synchro resolvers in their avionic application. They wanted to programmatically change the output sine wave frequencies whenever they needed. So here's our solution. We start with a MATLAB program our application engineers put together to accomplish the task. We've also pre-programmed the I/O board to generate 10 volt, 100 hertz sine waves. To change the output frequencies of the sine waves, you can go into this loop and set the prompt to yes. This will change the frequencies in increments of 200 hertz. So the first time it's changed, the output frequencies will be 300 hertz. And just to avoid any confusion, that's the board's initial output of 100 hertz plus an additional 200. If we say yes again, it increases another 200 hertz, and our frequencies are at 500 hertz. Since, for this demonstration, we can't show waveforms displayed with an oscilloscope, a couple of obvious questions to ask are, how do we verify the code actually works? And how do we know the channels are outputting the correct frequency? Since UEI manufactures a wide range of data acquisition products, our customers always have options. For this particular demonstration, we'll use our DNX AI 205. It's a versatile, high-speed analog input board that can both acquire and display the sine waves generated by the AO364. To show this, we'll use one of the many LabVIEW examples included in our PowerDNA software suite for Windows. This particular example is called Spectrum Analyzer. It has two output tabs. One is called Time Record, which displays the sine wave. And the other is Magnitude and Phase, which uses Fast Fourier Transform to show the frequency domain. When you run the MATLAB code, the first initial output of the AO364 is a 100 Hz sine wave. You can see it on the Time Record tab right here. Now let's look at the Magnitude and Phase to make sure the sine wave is at the programmed frequency. Let's say the output frequency of the 364 board is set to 500 Hz. We'll see a peak right at the 500 Hz mark, right here. Likewise, if it's 700 Hz output, you'll see the peak moving to 700 Hz. Repeat the process and the peak steps up an additional 200 Hz, from 700 to 900 to 1100. As you can see, UEI provides customers with the tools they need to accomplish their application requirements. With over 90 I/O boards, customers have an almost unlimited array of options. And all our COTS hardware is covered by a 3-year extendable warranty and an industry-leading 10-year availability guarantee. But if our customers still have questions or need assistance, our application engineers are available to help them achieve a solution. Got a question? Need help with your application or system? You can contact our technical support staff by phone, by email, or through the chatbot help link on our website.